please welcome to the stage Jim Stephenson.
So glad to be here, and wow, a full house. This is incredible. Really, you know, when I was coming back here, I knew that I was in for a treat working with this group, but it has surpassed every expectation. It has been truly a joy to bring this piece to life with these wonderful musicians. I will remember it forever. I've told them that, but I'm going to say it publicly anyway because it's been pretty special. A little bit about this piece, Games, we call it. First of all, what is a concerto for wind ensemble? When this project came into my mind, I actually thought to myself, what does that mean? And you'll notice the group playing all together softly. You'll notice the group playing all together loudly, admittedly. You'll hear them playing a note that sounds like they're tuning together at one point. All things that might make a large group of people focus on playing together as a wind ensemble. I mean, we're all impressed with football teams that have 11 players on them, but a group that's like 65 all doing things together, football is nothing compared to what they're doing. So you'll hear those things that I strive for, in addition to, of course, featuring different sections, different members, different families, different sounds of a wind ensemble. Another way I get my inspiration is by reading books. And at the time it came to write this piece, I was writing a book by a Hungarian author called Flow. And flow is something that we composers, and I think a lot of humans, are very interested in achieving, that state where you kind of lose sense of time and space and everything is just a wonderful state of being that you're existing in. And so I was reading this book, and I think it's page 79, if anyone is interested. The author described or named four games that humans play to get into that sense of flow. And so that became my piece. I was like, there is music in these four games. So after our introduction, which is not one of the games, we go to these games. And so the second movement is called Mimicry. And that is where you are inspired by someone or you copy someone, which sort of takes you out of yourself to sort of achieve this sense of flow. And so you will hear instruments imitating each other, sections imitating each other, families imitating each other. Almost every measure, somebody is imitating something that happened before them. So that was kind of a compositional challenge and a way to get into flow. We've changed the movement order a little bit, but I'm going to skip ahead a little bit. The fourth movement is actually going to be called something, it's Ilinx, which is otherworldly, trying to get into this state of altered reality, something we might do to just kind of get, again, away from thinking about ourselves. And so you'll hear the piece kind of go into this altered space. The last movement is called Agon, which is competition. I think that one's relatively obvious. We get into a sporting event, speaking of football, and we sort of lose ourselves in the moment and into the sport or competition. The elephant in the room, or the bingo machine in the room, is what is now the third movement, and this is Alea. Alea means chance. I'm the son of an engineer, and so it's hard for me to let things go too much to chance. I need some sort of structured. So my goal was to try to figure out a way to have a piece of music or a movement be unpredictable, but still have a sense of order to it. So in featuring the percussion section, you'll see them come forward for that movement. They will be playing what I identified as games of chance. Quarters, dice, deck of cards, rock, paper, scissors, a bingo machine. And every time they're playing these games, meanwhile, there's like lounge music going on over here. But every time they're playing these games, the outcome on the dice or on the cards or whatever determines what the wind ensemble plays. So every section is assigned a number. And if they call out a number, that section has to play. So that's my structured game of chance. It's the outlier of this piece. And I'm told there are about 1,696,716 options for that movement. So every time it happens, it'll be a world premiere. So that is a long description of a piece of music I simply just hope you enjoy. You're able to sit back and enjoy their abilities because it's a concerto for wind ensemble. And this is a fantastic wind ensemble you have here. So the world premiere of Concerto for Wind Ensemble Games. Hope you enjoy it. Thank you very much.